Welcome back to my channel. So it's been a long time since I have done a video on basic electronics. So the first chapter of this was conduction in semiconductors. In that chapter, I think I have done completely the theory part as well as problems has been discussed in that, in those series of videos. If you haven't seen those videos, please go back to that videos, okay? So this is continuation to the subject. This is the second chapter. This is semiconductor diode, okay? So see, in generally all our electronic subjects are mostly based on these diodes itself, okay? So from here onwards, we'll be learning what exactly this diode does and all, okay? So generally these diodes and all, we'll be using in all the integrated circuits and all everywhere, we'll be using these diodes, okay? So this is very basic concept as well as very important and the foundation of the complete electronics, is diode, okay? So we'll see what is the semiconductor diode and its characteristics and applications in this video. All right, so see, a p-n junction diode conducts only when it is in forward bias, okay? So when we have a p region and a n region, okay, the junction formed between those p and n, that is p-n junction, okay, that will conduct, that means electricity will pass through it and all. It happens only when it is in forward bias. Okay, what is this forward bias and all, we'll see in the coming video, okay? So in this respect, it resembles like a vacuum diode. So if it is working only when it is in forward bias, that means it is it is acting like a vacuum diode. All right, so for this reason, we will call p-n junction is called as junction diode, okay? This p-n junction is also called junction diode. What is the semiconductor diode? Semiconductor, since the junction is formed of semiconducting material, it is called a semiconductor diode. So this p-n junction material, whatever we are taking a semiconductor, and the junction is formed is because of the semiconductor, we call it as a semiconductor diode, okay? This is clear. Now that semiconductor diode, it will allow current to flow through it when it is forward bias, and it will effectively block the passage of the current when it is reverse bias. This enables a junction diode to be used as rectifier. So rectifier is nothing but it will convert AC to DC. Alright, so this process which is happening when it will allow current only in forward bias, and it will block the current in reverse bias. So this process, what is happening, that is nothing but it is a rectifier. That means that the junction diode is acting like a rectifier, okay? That is simply AC to DC. Alright, this rectifying action of the junction diode is perhaps its most important property, and in practice, the semiconductor diode is mainly used in electronic circuits as rectifier. So, this property, what it is behaving, like only in forward bias it will work and in reverse bias it will block the current. Because of this unique property which these diodes have, so these diodes are used as rectifiers in most of this electronic circuits, okay? See, the rectifying action of junction diode is the most important property, this rectifying action. So that's why this is mainly used in electronic circuits. All our electronic circuits, for example, your phone, your laptops, your TV, wherever these integrated circuits are there some or the other way these rectifiers are used. All right, so this symbol of the diode, what we are learning is this one, okay? Just like a triangle, okay? I think this you will be seeing in your labs and all, okay? If you draw it, it is something like this, okay? So see, the arrow head represents P region and A connected to it is anode. So this, the head of the arrow, this one, this is like an arrow, right? So this head, this is the P region. This is P region, this is N, all right? So this A is called as anode, okay? And the vertical bar, this one is the N region, and K is connected to it. This is the K which is connected to it. This is called as cathode. This is anode and this is cathode. This is a basic symbol of a diode, all right? So now we'll see what is forward bias and reverse bias, okay? So see, this is a diode, and this is a I mean this is in reverse bias and this is a forward bias. So you're giving some supply over here. Okay, now this is called as forward bias and this is reverse bias. See, the positive terminal of it is connected to the anode. Okay, if the positive terminal and negative terminal, positive and negative, as it is, if it is connected, positive negative terminals, then it is forward bias. Just for your remembrance, I'm telling you. So see, we are considering this as positive and negative, right, this diode. So for this, exactly, if you're giving the supply positive and negative, this is forward bias. Just to avoid the confusion, I'm explaining you this. Okay, so if this is a negative side of it is connected to this one, okay, and the positive side is connected, that means it's obviously reverse bias. Okay, see, now this junction diode is acting as a rectifier, we are telling, right? How it is, we will see now. So a junction diode conducts under forward bias condition, but blocks conduction under reverse bias condition. That is what we were learning. Blocks conduction in reverse bias, conducts in forward bias. Just blindly remember this, that a diode will conduct only in forward bias and it will block conduction in reverse bias. That's it. Okay, see, if we are applying some alternating voltage, I mean this one, is applied across the diode terminals, okay, then the diode is forward bias during positive half cycles and it is reverse bias during the negative half cycle. So when you are applying this voltage over here, that means conduction is taking place only in the positive cycles. That means if it is conducting, that means positive cycle. If it is not conducting, like we said, if it is blocking, then it will be negative cycle, negative half cycles. Okay, hence if one single diode you are using for rectification, that means for one diode, like you have used one diode, right? In the coming upcoming videos and all, I mean topics, you'll be having half wave rectification, full wave rectification, and still you'll be finding ripple factor and all. Okay, so there some points will be using two diodes, four diodes and all. Okay, so if you're using single diode, that means your the conduction is happening only in the positive half cycle. So that will result in half wave. That means the wave will be in the half suppose if this is the general sinusoidal wave, okay, that means it is conducting both positive, this is positive and this is negative, all right, it is conducting both positive and negative regions. Okay, generally if it is half wave rectification, that means it is acting only in the half wave and the positive only, this negative part it is not conducting. So you will draw something like this. Okay, this part no conduction. Okay, so for single diode, this is it happens only in the positive half cycle. So suppose if the conduction occurs in both positive and half cycles, that means there are two or four diodes are used. This results in full wave rectification. Okay, so that means if you are using three, when suppose this is diode D1, okay, this is conducting, again D2, that will be conducting, then you will have negative cycle. Again D3, that will be positive cycle. Again D4, you know, in this way you can for full wave rectification, it will continue, it will form like a sinusoidal wave. Okay, for that reason we need to have two or more diodes. Okay, I think this is clear. Half wave rectification, only single diode, and full wave rectification, two or four diodes. So this is how a junction diode will act as a rectifier. I think this is clear and this is very important topic. The next topic what we're going to learn in the next video is about half wave rectification. So by that, I'll just explain you in brief. Half wave means it is occurring in the positive half cycle. Okay, rectification means AC to DC. I think that's clear, right? Only the half wave the cycles what we have drawn, that is what we are going to learn in the upcoming video. Okay, this is very important. Please go through this. If you like this video, please like the video, and if you still want to know any more other topics also, please let me know. Yeah, I think this is useful. Thank you, take care.